Hello, welcome back to this channel Gain Java Knowledge, and today in this video we will discuss about how to schedule the job by using cron expression with Spring Boot project. In the last video we have already discussed about how to schedule the job by using fixed rate, fixed delay and initial delay parameters as a parameter of @ scheduled annotation. And so let's start in this video. Today we will discuss how to schedule the job by using cron expression, and we'll also discuss about how multiple jobs work parallelly in Spring Boot. Let's see in the code. In the previous video we have already discussed about there are couples of ways that decide how job should run by using fixed rate, and we can also use fixed delay, and we can also use fixed delay string, and we can use spring expression here, and we will define the time here in application.properties file. So no need to change the code while we are scheduling the job. This application I have already created in the previous video. So today we will learn how to schedule the job by using cron expression. So I will remove it from here, and here I will use cron is equal to, here I will use 6 star, that is 4th, 5th and 6th, and it is the format of cron expression. First star is means for second, and second star for minute, and third for hours, and fourth for day of month, and fifth star represent month, and sixth is for day of week. Okay, if I want to run my job after every 5 seconds, then I will write here 5, and now I will run the application, scheduler application. Now you will see the output on the console. Here you can see the output, that is 50, and after 5 seconds it will execute, and after 5 seconds, and that is the output. Now if you want to execute your job every day at 6, then you can write here at like this, and we'll run the application, then this job will be execute every 6 on every day. And we can also provide the weekdays, like on which day we want to run this job. For this we will write here Monday to Friday, on weekdays this job will execute at 6. This expression is confusing, so you can go to the cron tab guru and enter your expression and check what is the actual meaning of this cron expression. Okay, I show you here. I will type cron tab guru and we'll copy this expression and open this, and here I will paste my expression, and here you can see the meaning of this expression is at every minute past hour 80 on every day of week from Monday through Friday at 6 it will run. There is one more important thing to remember, is that by default multiple jobs running on a single thread. What does it mean? It means if we have multiple jobs like this, now I will write multiple jobs here. I will use here fixed rate, that is 1000 L, and copy the same from here and paste here. It is my first job, and it will be the second job. Removing this from here. Now cron time, first job, second job, And I will declare like this: if this job locks the thread, then second job would not be executed until first one is over. The job will start when the context is up, and but we would expect here both will run on the same time. Let's see the output on console. Now I will run this application and both job will be start, and here you can see the output on the console. Both jobs are executing one by one. Here you can see the output on console. First job execute at 39 and second execute on 40, but we are expecting both will be execute on 39 and then again on 40 40, but it's not here because single thread is available here. But since the first job will lock the thread for 1 second, so second job will execute when first job will over. So by default both job will not run at the same time, but we can change its configuration and we can provide pool size, that is the maximum allowed number of threads in the form of integer. Here it will decide the pool size for threads dedicated for scheduling, and in the application.properties file we can define the size for threads. So here I will write spring.task.schedule.pool.size. pool.size is equal to 10. By default it will be 1, and if we assign 10 and restart the job, save it, now we'll run the job. Now you will see the output on the console. Here you can see the output on the console. Here I did some mistake. Here I need to define scheduling. So now I will run the application. Now you will see the output on the console. Now both job will be executed parallelly. Here you can see the output. First job execute on 52 and the second job also execute on the same time. Like second job execute on 53 and first job also execute on the 53. So both jobs executed on the same time. Now you can see each job is running by different threads, and now both will execute parallelly. Okay, thanks for watching this video.